बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलामुअलैकुम स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम योर मैथ टीचर शहबाज अली। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी कंप्लीटेड आवर एक्सरसाइज 1.2। नाउ इन द टुडे लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस सम डेफिनेशन दैट इज द बेस ऑफ योर 1.3। फर्स्ट, टाइप्स ऑफ अ सेट। एंड यू नो दैट व्हाट इज अ सेट? अ सेट इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ वेल डिफाइंड एंड डिस्टिंक्ट ऑब्जेक्ट्स इज कॉल्ड सेट। Now types. First, finite sets. Second, infinite sets. Third, empty sets. Let's start with finite sets. A set having a finite number of elements is called a finite set. In simple words, a set has an ending point. A set and its elements R ends at a specific point. You can see here we have an example. A set of natural number less than 10. Less than 10 means 9. So 9 is the ending point. Element of these sets are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And you can see the set has an ending point, that is 9. B is equal to the set of vowels in the English alphabets, and these are 5: A, E, I, O, U. So students, you examine that these two sets are countable and its elements are countable. You can see, so we can say that A and B sets are finite. Now let's move forward. Example number C, the set of populations of Pakistan. This is a difficult task but countable. Now D, the set of hairs of your head. This is also a most difficult task but it is possible. You can do this. So we can say that C and D set are also a finite set because they are countable of its elements. So these sets are finite. Let's move forward our next definitions, that is infinite set. A set having unlimited number of elements is called an infinite set. In simple word, a set of its element has no ending point. It is infinity. So we can say that infinite set. Here we have some examples. You can see the set of counting numbers that are n mean natural. And its elements are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. There has no ending point. B, the set of odd numbers. Odd numbers means, students remember it. The odd number starts from 1 and 3, 5, 7, 9 and so on. Next, the set of whole number. The whole numbers start from 0. So students, this is a major difference between natural number and the whole number. The whole number start from 0 and the natural number start from 1. It is possible to find the last element or member of a finite set, but it is not possible to find the last element or member of the infinite set. So here we have example number 2. Our task is that we have 4 parts. We separate the finite and infinite sets. You can see here both first and second parts are countable. So we can say that the first and second are limited elements, so this is a finite set. And the third and fourth are not countable of its element, so this set are infinite set. Our third definition is empty set or null. Both are same. I will give you simple example. If you have nothing, it means you have empty set. For example, when there is nothing in my pocket, it means my pocket is empty. Similarly, when there is no element in the set, it means set is empty. Here we have example, a set having no element is known as empty set or null set. And this set is represented by Greek symbol and this symbol name is phi. Or simply we can also write it is denoted by empty brackets. and the curly brackets. So students, here we have some example. A set of 100 feet tall boy. It is not fine. You cannot find in the world the 100 feet tall boy. Second, the set of days of 25 hours. It is impossible because in a day we have 24 hours. The set of counting numbers between 1 and 2. So there is no counting number between 1 and 2. Last definition is singleton set. A set has only one element. We can say that this is a singleton set. Here we have example. We have only one set A, similarly B, and similarly 1 by 2. This is an example of a singleton set.
Equal and equivalent sets. In the previous classes, you know that the concept of one-to-one correspondence. Now we are discussing it again. Suppose we have two sets, set A and set B. Now we are establishing one-to-one correspondence or not by the following way. We have a set A and set B, and we assign establish A to 1 to A, 2 to B, 3 to C, 4 to D. We establish every element of set A to the every other element of the set B, and this symbol is a equivalent symbol. It is denoted by these symbols. Now check this. Two sets, remember these definitions, two sets are called equivalent if and only if one-to-one correspondence can be established between them. You can see here we successfully established one-to-one correspondence. Now we will see another example. Now we have a set A, we have a set C and set D, and we established the one-to-one correspondence. But you can see 1 to A, 3 to E, 5 to I, 7 to O, but O is remaining. You can see that to the element U of the set D is not the element of set C. So it is not establishing the one-to-one correspondence. That is why C is not equivalent to the D. It is represented by this symbol. Definition: two sets are called non-equivalent if one-to-one correspondence cannot be established between them. You can see here it is not established one-to-one correspondence because the element D, element U of the set D, is not a element of a set C. You can see here, that is why this example is not the non-equivalent set. Now we have example number 1. We have two set, set A and set B, and set A element has 2, 4, 6, 8, and set B elements are 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. You can see here we establish a connection, 1-to-1 correspondence, but 9 element of set B is not the element of set A. That is why it is not possible to establish 1-to-1 correspondence because two sets are not equivalent. Let's move forward. Our next definition is equal set. Suppose we have two sets, set P and set Q. We can see we establish a connection, 1-to-1 correspondence, 1 to 3, 2 to I, 1, 3 to 5, 5, 4 to 2, and 5 to 4. So all the elements of the set P is also the element of a set Q. So we can say that this is the equivalent, and we can assign this symbol with this P is equal to Q. So this is the example of a equivalent set. Now discuss subset and superset of a set. Remember this, if the element of set A, this is set A, is also the element of a set B, then we can say that A is called the subset of a set B. It is denoted by this symbol. This symbol means subset symbol. This is a subset symbol. Here you can see A have element 2, 4, 6, 8 and 10, and B has element 1 to 10. We can see every element of the set A is also the element of a set B. You can see 2, here we also 2, similarly 4, 6, 8 and 10, these are also the element of a set B. You can see here, now we can say that A, set A is a subset of a B. This is a subset symbol. And we read it as set A is a subset of a set B. Now, every set is also called subset of itself. For example, A, subset A, and B is a subset of a B. Now, superset. If A subset B, then set B is called superset of A. Similarly, B superset A then can be read as B is the, remember this, B is superset of A. Proper and improper subset of a set. Here we have two sets, set number A, the set of natural number less than 9, remember this, less than 9, and set B, the set of first 9 natural numbers. These also are 9 elements. Here we also have 9 elements, and we establish a 1-to-1 correspondence. You can see here that A element also the A set element also the set of B. Now we can see that A is the subset of B. Now you can see another example. We have a A set and its elements are A, O and U. And we have another set B. You can see its elements are A, E, I, O, U. You can see here A are also the element of a set B, because every element of the set A is also the element of a set B. Now, but B are not the set of element of a set A. You can see we cannot find I and E in the set A. So that is why we can see here the set A called the proper subset of a set B.
First question is, which of the following sets is the empty set? Here we have 5 sets, and our task is that we have to identify that which set is empty and which set is not. So firstly discuss what is empty set. A set having no element is known as an empty set or null set. For example, a set but it does not have any elements, we say that this set is empty set. Now our first question number 1 and first part, the set of whole number less than 1. Yes, you know that the whole number starts from 0. So we have a less than 1 number, that is 0. So that it is not empty set. Number 2, the set of English alphabets between U and E. You know that there is no English alphabet between U and V. So this is empty set. Number 3, the set of all vowels other than A and O. You know that these are A, E, I, O, U are the vowels. So this set is not empty set. Number 4, the set of natural number less than 1. You know that here we have no less than number than 1. The natural number starts from 1 as so on. So this set is empty set. Number 5, the set of even numbers which are called odd number. This statement is false, because even numbers cannot become the odd. So here we have part 2, part 4 and part 5 are empty set, because such elements do not exist. Here we do not have an exist and elements, and these sets are called empty sets. Our second question is, separate the finite and infinite set from the following. Firstly discuss what is finite and infinite. So you know that a set having a finite number of elements is called finite. A set, in simple word, a set has an ending point. We say that this is a finite set. And on the other hand, we have an infinite set. You can see here a set having unlimited number of elements is called an infinite set. You can see we have an example of natural number. A natural number starts from 1 but it has no ending point. We can say that these sets are called infinite set. So here we have question number 2 we have to identify which set is finite and which is not finite. Number one, letter of word halla gulla. So this is a limited element. So we can say this is a finite set. Number two, B, the set of natural numbers. You know that natural numbers start from 1 and has no ending point. So it is a not a finite. Number 3, C, numbers of the day in a year. The number of day in a year is limited. So that is why this set is finite set. So Islamic month is also the example of finite set. Now E is equal to 3, 6, 9 and as so on. It has no ending point element. So we can say this set is a finite set. F is equal to C, F, I, M, O, R, U. This is a limited and has an ending point U. You can see here. So F is a finite set. Last G. 1 divided by 2, 2 divided by 4 and 3 divided by 6. And it has no ending points. So we can say that this is an infinite set. Here I write for you. A, C, D and F are finite set because they have an ending point, where B, E and G are infinite set because they have no ending element. Let's move forward our question number 3. Here, which of the following pair of the set are equivalent or not equivalent? So firstly discuss what is equivalent and non-equivalent. If we have two sets, set A and set B, and both have same number of elements, we say that this is a equivalent set. So this is a symbol of equivalent set. On the other hand, if we have two sets and their number of elements are not same, we can say this set is not equivalent set. Now our question number 3 is, we have to identify just which set is equivalent and which set is not equivalent. Number 1, A, you can see A set has an element 1 and 2. But on the other hand, we have a B set, it has element 1, 3 and 7. The number of elements A and number of elements B are not equal. So that is why this set is non-equivalent. Number 2, you can see here we have two elements and we also have in the set B, we have two elements, both are same. So this is a equivalent set. Number 3, you can see here, we have four number of elements here in the set A and we have also four number of elements in set B. Both are same. We can say A is equal to B and this is a equivalent set. Number 4, you can see here we have five elements here and also we have five elements here. Both are same. So this is a example of equivalent set. Number 5, you can see here we have 5 number of elements, but on the other hand we have 4 elements. Both are not same. That is why this is not equivalent set. Number 6, the set of 4 natural numbers. Here we have 4 elements and on the other hand B, the set of 3 wild animals. Here we have 3 elements. So 4 and 3 are not equal each other. So this part is not equivalent, non-equivalent sets. Last, the set of even rivers of Punjab and the set of colors in Pakistan. You also know that here has two colors, so both sets are not equal. That is why this set is an example of non-equivalent. So I repeat here, part 1, 5, 6 and 7 are not equivalent, and on the other hand, second, third and the last part are equivalent. Question number 4 is, which of the following pairs of sets are equal sets? Our task is that here we have some parts and we have to identify which part is equal set and which part is not equal set. So let's move forward. Firstly, the definition of equal set. Here you can see this is an equal set. Here we have two set P and here we have second set Q. Here we have, firstly we check the total number of elements in the board set. Here I have 5 elements and also here I have 5 elements. Now check it one by one. The first is 1. Now search it 1 in this set. Yes, it is 1. Similarly 2. Yes, 2. 3, 4, 5. Similarly, 3, 4, 5. So both set we can see has element same. So P is equal to Q is the equal set. Now move forward our question number 4. First part is A is equal to B, C, D, E. And the second part is equal to, second set is equal to B, A, E, D, C. Now find, you find both set has 5 elements same. Here both set has 5 elements. Now check element one by one. Now A, similarly A, B, C, D, E. Now you can see here B, C, D, E. Now both sets are same elements. So we can say that this is an equal set. Now move forward our second part. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now set B is equal to 1 plus 0 we have 1. 1 plus 2 we have 2. You can see here. And 4 plus 1 we have 5. So both sets are same with the element wise and the number wise same. You can see here we have 1 to 5 elements. Similarly here we have 1 to 5 elements. Now third part is A is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. But here we have only 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Now check it one by one. 6 minus 2 we have 4. Now 4 minus 1 we have 5. So we have two same elements. Now 4 minus 2 we have 2, 3 minus 1 we have 2, 2 minus 2 we have 0. Now both set you can see elements are not same. That is why this set is not equal set. Last part, a set of even numbers less than 9. So you can see set of even number less than 9 are 2, 4, 6, 8. But here we also have a 0. So that is why this is not equal. So we can say that here we have a solution. First and second part are equal set and the third and fourth part are not equal set. Now our question number 5 is, here we have A is equal to A, B, C, B set, C set, D set, as you can see on your screen. Then we have to find which of the following statement are true. Here we have a proper symbol. Now move forward our book. Here you can see this example, A is equal to A, O, U and B is equal to A, E, I, O, U. Now you can see all the elements of A set are also the element of B set. Now we can say that A set is the proper subset of B. I again repeat, A set is the proper subset of B. We can write it as this is a symbol of proper set. Now our question number 5 is, here we have first part, A is a proper subset of B. Is it true or false? So firstly check it. Here we have A, B and C. Now you can see in the B set, here we do not find the A. So first is false statement. Now number 2, B is the proper subset of D. B and D. This is D set and this is B set. Now here we have B, C and D. So similarly B, C and D, all the elements of B are also the element of D. So this is a true statement. Now third part, C is a proper subset of D. Is it true or false? So firstly check it. This is a C set and this is a D set. Now here we have D, C and E. But in the D set we do not have any element of E. That is why this is a false statement. Number 4, A is the proper subset of D. Now here we have A, D and C. Or you can check it in the D set, A, B and D. All the elements of A also are also the element of D. So this part is the true statement. Number 5, B is the proper subset of D. So here we have B, here we have C set. Now but here we do not have the B element. So that is why this statement is false. Last, C is the proper subset of A. Now you can see this is a C. Here we have element C, D and E. But in the A set, we do not have any element of E. That is why both are not same. So this is a false statement. So students, in this lecture we will cover our exercise 1.3. Our exercise is completed. In the next lecture we will discuss the exercise of our chapter number 1. I hope you understand well. If you have any questions, you can ask me. I will give you an answer as soon as possible. So take care. Allah Hafiz.